wonderful, wonderful show today. I am so excited. Even though I'm like a grown-up lady.
A grown-up lady?
Yes. Zendaya's in the house! Plus, one of our favorite couples and dearest friends, Holly Robinson Peete and Rodney Peete!
Yes!
Amazing show! And
the uber talented Loretta Devine is here!
I do want to bring up this little list because we are fortunate enough to have a male host.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
So I want to take advantage of this opportunity to go through a couple of things from the male perspective. Now, I came across the list about the secrets men keep from women.
Secrets?
Yes. Yes. Secrets.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, hold on a second. See, let me just clear something out. There's no secrets. We just have a different way of communicating.
Yeah, you hold it in and don't say nothing.
No, look.
Or you lie.
Okay, Can I?
Or you cover up the lie.
Okay, can I please?
And then you have your boy lie for you.
Guys, can you back me up here, please? Can I speak now?
Yes, you
Thank
can.
You.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Look, yes, we are very simple.
Secretive. Oh, simple.
Simple creatures.
Yes?
Yes, so we communicate differently.
Okay.
We are task-oriented, right? Very single-focused. He said, yes. There you go. Single-focused, task-oriented. You guys are analytical. You're intuitive. You have the emotions, and you're sensitive, right? All of that. But we just keep it simple, and that's why when you ask us questions about what's going on with us and we say nothing, just take it for what it is. There's really nothing going on. Thank you, yes. And don't read anything into what we're saying. We always tell you what we're thinking. And don't read in between the lines. There is no lines in between. We got nothing going on between the lines, right? So
okay.
When we ask you, it's the same thing. When we ask you, just let us know. We're not good at reading minds.
Okay? Well, since you're translating, let's translate a couple of these.
Okay, give me some.
Okay. Were you checking out that woman as she was walking by? What is usually the answer? What woman?
You gonna be incriminating me based on what
yes,
I'm saying?
This is...
Yes, yes, we check out that woman.
Okay.
But let me tell you
we
why.
Like the truth.
Let me explain, because we're very visual beings. You know, we're the back to the caveman times. We're the procreators. We want to procreate. So visually, even though our brain might not even notice that this person walked by, our eyes are just.
Wow!
I'm telling you the truth. Can I tell the truth?
Wow.
Am I telling the truth? I'm telling the truth. This is how it works.
Maybe
because
her butt
we're always
didn't
looking.
Look good. My eyes just moved. But sure, her, she doesn't look better.
Do you want to hear
you.
The truth?
No,
do you
that
hear-
sounds like malarkey.
See? Uh-huh.
Okay.
You can't handle the truth.
Okay.
This is what's going on.
All right, here's a good one.
Hit me.
Making love is great, but sometimes I just want to have sex.
Why do you have to whisper it?
Because there might be children in the building.
Okay. Just have sex. Yes, absolutely. Sometimes, again, we want to procreate. Sometimes when the urge comes, we just want to pull some hair and we want to get to the business. Listen, ladies, if you cannot handle the truth, don't ask me a question. I'm giving it to you straight, okay?
Okay.
Fellas, are you with me on this?
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
Hit me again.
Sometimes, this was on the list, sometimes I'd rather you just be quiet.
Would I say that?
Yeah, no, I'm just saying, is that a secret you have? A secret wish?
It's not really a secret. You know, sometimes when we're just sitting there or in the car even, you know, you commented on me and my brother driving for 2 hours and not speaking to each other. It's not because we're mad. It's just because we're guys and sometimes we don't need to speak. It's okay. It's okay not to speak sometimes, ladies.
Okay.
It's all right. All right. Nothing bad's going to happen.
Okay.
You got something
should
else?
We even have a talk show? Because I can't talk anymore.
Again, it's all about communicating, you know?
Okay.
And it's important to have open lines of communication. But couples also have to know when they're expecting too much of each other. That's another issue sometimes.
When you expect too much.
Yeah, you know, when you go into a relationship and then, you know, obviously you love the person.
Okay, I understand. Yes, I expect the door to be open.
Can't finish a sentence. What do I have to do? I can't finish a sentence. You jump
Ooh!
In and it's like,
oh my God, we're having a fight right now.
relationship on shaky grounds.
I am so sorry. Okay.
I can't go on like this.
No, okay. But I've been working so hard on this.
Well,
haven't I?
Not
ladies?
Hard enough.
I've been working on it.
Don't back her up. Okay. Don't back her up. Continue, please.
I am so going to work on this for the rest of the year. I am not going to interrupt you. I'm going to talk at a minimum. And I'm going to appreciate all the gentlemanly things
they
you do for
you.
Me.
They're like, she's not going to do it.
Oh, my gosh. All right, well, we have a few more topics we want to go over, but we thought it would be fun to save us from this tragedy that we're having right now, but bring someone out to join us. She's an activist, an actress, a singer, and a Disney Channel star. Please welcome the talented Zendaya!
I'm good.
Welcome to the show.
This is cool.
Well, yes, right?
The panel's very official. Mm-hmm.
So we were talking about relationships and expectations, but we're going to move out of that arena to save our marriage. And we're going to move on to something that you have a lot to talk about. What the youth and their participation online and social media and you really handle your business on social media,
Thank
I must
you.
Say.
I think, you know, when it comes to social media, yes, I have a problem, you know what I'm saying? I check too much, okay, you know, and I try to work on that. I try to, like, not be on my phone as much, especially not during dinner and stuff
well,
like
nice.
That.
You that's know real what I mean? That's real considerable.
I try, and it's hard.
Thank you.
But you know, I think as much as social media can get in the way, it's also, you know, a very important tool. You know, we can use it for good. Mm-hmm. And there is ways that we can, you know, try to use our voice or our followers for something more than promoting something, you know
yes.
what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But promoting something that we're passionate about and that we, you know, we love. So I don't know. I think that, you know, I think it's up to my generation to kind of make that change.
Mm-hmm. Yes. You know? I like that. You post a lot of uplifting and very funny, but also inspirational things. But you also talk about some of your social media tips. Mm-hmm. And I would love to hear those.
One, I would say try not to get too consumed into it. Because, like, especially when you do what we do, you know,
yes.
you allow people to kind of have opinions on your life.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, you know what I mean? So you can't allow yourself to just be consumed too much by it. Every now and then, delete your apps and just, like, chill for a second. Like, you have to force yourself to let it go.
What happens when people respond and they leave comments that are not so nice? How do you deal with that?
Well, I mean, first of all, I've gotten to a point, I think, now where I've become comfortable with Zendaya.
There you go.
To where, you know, it doesn't really get to me as much, you know
right.
what I mean?
You don't do like Cedric the Entertainer, he was like, block, delete.
I mean, you could block them, but you have to block a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? And that's just too much, you know, so
yes.
I just, you know, and I always think, you gotta think in like the compassion sense of it, you know what I mean? That person online somewhere that I'll never meet in my life, they're going through something that I have no idea about, you know what I
yes.
mean? And whatever they're going through, it could have been the highlight of their day to diss me, and okay, like, all right, that's fine, I'll take that.
I love that you say that.
Okay,
you know.
What about whole thinking?
Did you see that?
No. We started talking at the same time,
no.
and I just got there earlier than you. I got there quicker.
You know what?
So it's not.
We're not going to do this in front of company.
Okay, sorry.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
I have parents.
Yeah,
yes. Yes. Okay.
Okay. Well, you. One of your tips was think before you tweet.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
There's impulse tweeting. You know what I mean?
What's
like,
that? What's that? What's
it's
that?
Basically where, you know, you see a hater and you're like, oh, I'm about to clap back. And you're just like, ready. And you're just, and then it
turns. Do it again,
turns,
do it again.
Clap back, right?
Clap and it back. Turns, I have no idea what that means, but it sounds great.
And it turns into something that, like, becomes very negative and like just explodes.
And then you get into a whole back and forth and you're giving it more power than it should have.
That's what I'm saying. So you gotta sit and you gotta think and you gotta take the time to come up with a response. If you're going to even respond, sometimes you don't need to. Sometimes it's not worth your time. But if you do, you know, take the time to think about what you're gonna say. You know what I mean? Because internet, it's there forever. You delete it, someone can still screenshot it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so it's still there.
That's a good point.
I always try to say something nice to them because usually if they're hating, they're coming from a really painful place or something, and shoot them with a little kindness.
Kill them with kindness.
Yes. Wow. Now, Zendaya, you often encourage your fans to embrace who they are, flaws and all. And the other day you tweeted, when you're secure with your insecurities, that in itself makes you secure. Yes. Hashtag my preach of the day. I love that.
I was in the studio and I started talking out, and we have like just times where we just talk in the studio and we're just vibing or whatever. And I said that and we were like,
that's deep.
Tweet it. Like, that's deep.
Clap that.
It's okay.
You put up a video of you going makeup free. You talk about, let's take a look at that one.
Not trying to have a preach moment, but it should not be a phenomenon if a girl decides to or not to wear makeup. If you want to beat that face down, then beat it down. If you want to go natural, then go natural. Do you, boo-boo. Be happy.
Do you, boo-boo.
Do you, boo-boo.
Boris is so overwhelmed with the sayings right now. He's going to be at home telling me to clap boo-boo and slash back. He's going to have it all wrong.
Single-minded focus, people. Yeah. Single-minded focus.
Zendaya, why is it so important for you to get these messages out there?
I mean, honestly, because, you know, everybody, I think, you know, misconception, I think, like, with women at least, is we don't necessarily just wake up and put on makeup because we feel insecure. That's not always the reason why we put on makeup. Sometimes it's fun. Like, we enjoy doing it.
I love it when I wake up and I just go, I'm going to put on some makeup today. I just love it.
No, but we get such a bad, it's fun. It's
playing with color, and you can try new things. Like, to me, at least, I like to do my own makeup because it's fun for me. Like, I enjoy it, you know? So it's kind of getting that people to either, you know, embrace not wearing makeup if that's what they want to do and being comfortable in their own skin. But also, it's fine if you wear makeup. Like, there's nothing wrong with it, you know?
Yes.
It's like having fun. Like, so,
And, well, there was another video that I can really relate to because I feel the same way about hair.
I already know.
You know, I change my hair a lot. You change your hair a lot.
All the time. That's all I do. Just change my hair a lot. All day, every day.
And, you know, a lot of people took some...
Continue.
People react to these changes. Let's take a look.
So many people get stressed out every time I wear a different hairstyle on the red carpet. It is called a wig, people, okay? W-I-G. Say it with me now. Wig.
Hysterical. We have more with Zendaya after this.
Model for many young girls. So what's the one thing that most of your fans ask you?
People are like, how'd you get so confident? And what are you like? And I think that's like a constant question because I have a big majority of my fans is a lot of young women. You know what I mean? And that's a constant question, especially for a lot of tall girls. They're like, you know, I'm tall. I don't want to wear heels because I'm tall. And, you know, I try to at least reach out to them and talk to them and just honestly say it takes time. You know what I mean? Confidence is not something that you just like born like the cutest thing in the world. You know what I mean? Like you just have to like grow and learn, and I'm still learning. Like I'm not 100% confident, but I've learned every step of the way, and I just keep trying to, I guess, fall in love with myself more. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So.
Well, before the show, you surprised a couple of your young fans, including our own Sophie and Nicholas. Let's take a look.
Let's take a look at the tape.
Just open it.
Hi. How is everybody?
What's your name, pretty lady?
Hi.
What's your name?
Check it out.
Okay. I can do this. Everybody squeeze in.
Nice. Hey, guys. How was it this morning seeing Zendaya?
It was awesome. Cool.
Were you surprised?
Yeah.
It's hard to trick you, Sophie. Were you surprised?
Yeah. You were.
How about you, Nicholas?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Madison, did you have a good time?
Yes, I really did. It was the best day of my life.
Wow. That's amazing.
No pressure.
No pressure.
You're not only the star of Casey Undercover, but you were also a producer on this show.
Woo!
Give it up. Why was it so important for you to produce that series?
I feel like I got to a point in my career, I was like, you know what? I have the ability to say yes and no. Like, I have that control, and I can be a part of something, you know what I mean? So I was lucky enough to be with Disney Channel that was like, of course, like, we would love for you to come on board and be a part of something, like, behind the scenes, you know? So
we have a clip. Let's take a look.
Freeze! This is your last chance. Give me that file, puppet.
The name's not puppet. The name's Casey.
Whoa. Hey, clap that. Yes.
It's clap back, and you only use it when you're trying to, like, you know, correct somebody.
Oh, okay. Clap back.
That's all right.
So you just got back from South Africa.
Yes, mm-hmm. When you were participating in the UN AIDS conference.
Yeah, it was amazing. I learned a lot, and what was crazy for me is, you know, AIDS in general is going down, but in young people, it's going up.
So you're encouraging testing?
Absolutely. Yes. You know, I met a lot of young people that were on the same boat, and just kind of make it cool to get tested, make it cool to be a
be
part
safe.
Of the movement, you
That's
know?
Amazing. Be responsible. I love it.
Awesome. Well, another project you recently supported is very close to your family's heart, and because most people view teens as very apathetic these days. Mm-hmm. But photographer Matthew Jordan Smith, who's in the audience today, he asked you to write the foreword for this book, Future American President. Tell us about this amazing book.
Well, first of all, he brought this book, and I thought it was the coolest thing I've ever seen because I'm very inspired by young people, you know what I mean? And the future generations, you know, we are literally the future presidents and the future, like, we're going to run the world, you know? So I think it's just kind of really cultivating those young minds and kind of being a part of that. So when I saw the book and all the kids' comments and all the amazing things that, like, these kids should be running the world. Like, they have amazing ideas, and they're so beyond their years. So when he showed me it, it was just like, I was like, of course I'll write it. You know what I mean? I'm totally down for being a part of it. So
actually, our son Nicholas is on the back cover. Do we have a picture of that? There he is.
Nico.
Nicole's twin.
That's my twin. Well, Zendaya, I want to thank you so much for stopping by. We
Absolutely.
Love you so much, and we're so happy and proud of you.
Thank you.
Thank you for that. You can check out the show, Casey Undercover, Sundays on the Disney Channel. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Holly.
I'm Rodney.
And we're coming up next on our friend, the Boris and Nicole show. Can you believe it? They have a show. It's not just in our living room anymore. It's actually on TV.
Our next guests are a dynamic duo. She's an accomplished actress, and he is a former NFL superstar.
Together, yes, they found their biggest success as husband and wife and parents. Please welcome the stars of the new docuseries For Pete's Sake and our good friends, Holly Robinson Peete and Rodney Peete.
Blocking my light.
Sorry about that.
You're blocking my light on my selfie stick, huh?
Congratulations, guys.
Thank you. Yay! Welcome.
Holly, let me ask you before we get to...
Welcome to the Boris and Nicole Show.
Did he just interrupt me? Yes.
It thumbs up.
Do you guys talk over each other just naturally?
No, we always yield to each other and we let there be nice pregnant pauses in between each thought that Rodney Peete has. I stop, I let him flesh it out, and then when I'm sure he's finished, that's when I start to talk.
Seems a lot of sarcasm here, I don't know. Well, there may lightning strike down on you.
Why is that?
Why can't we just talk at our own pace and with our own thoughts without you
we're
guys
gonna have
just...
dinner and just talk about this later.
Well, you guys are on TV now, so you have to, you know, you have some rules. But when we were all together, the four of us, and we spent many nights together,
yes,
it's a free-for-all. Yes. It's a free-for-all.
That's why Boris and I kind of sneak away.
That's right.
Yes. You have four beautiful children.
Right.
And you're constantly balancing parenthood. Aww. Yes.
Aww.
And they really look like that. Yeah. Like, we have crashed at their house before, and the whole family wakes up at breakfast, and they're all just radiant.
They all hold hands like that. All day long, they hold hands.
Blowing
in the wind.
There's a wind machine in your house.
They each have their own separate wind fan.
Yes. Well,
like a Mariah Carey fan just everywhere they go.
Yes. Well, now, you guys are superstars now, and you have your own, you know, docuseries for Pete's sake.
So here's the deal. I mean, it's just the timing feels right. The Oprah Winfrey Network feels right. We have a great production company called Tremendous. And it just, it's all about timing. And then I had to put a gun to Rodney's head.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, everybody in your family has so much personality. Your mom is stealing the show, I hear.
Dolores adds an interesting element to the show. She really does. Yes. As a mother-in-law, she really does. So yes. There's very little conflict with Dolores and I.
Of course not. That's all edited out. No. We should say that my mom is going to be 80, but she thinks she's 40, right? She's looking for a man.
Therein lies the problem.
Actively. So it's interesting, but she's definitely the breakout star for sure.
I heard you just got a tattoo. Is that true?
Yes, it's a gramp stamp. And it's her fifth one. So. We're going to be documenting that, and much to Rodney's chagrin.
Well, you guys just celebrated your 20-year anniversary. Congratulations. That's amazing.
Well, you know, a lot of people write in and ask us about how to stay and married, how to keep a relationship, how to start a relationship. So we thought, you know, after 10 years of marriage, we're not experts, 20 years of marriage.
Yes, you are. In this town, after 10 years, you're experts.
Well, we thought that you both could help us answer some of these questions and relationship dilemmas. So,
okay.
Are you guys down for that?
Absolutely.
Sure.
Let's meet Christian and Haley.
Hi, guys.
Come on in. Hi, guys.
Hi.
How are you? Good to see you.
Hi.
Have a seat.
Yes.
Yes. We'll be banned to the
back.
To the back.
Yes. Line up. Wait. Well, excuse me.
Sorry. Sorry. My bad. We've switched before. How dare you?
Not really.
No.
Jokes.
Only in my dreams.
Haley, let's start with you. What's your biggest issue?
Well, Christian and I like to go out. And I feel like when we're out with my girlfriends, he's just a little too flirtatious. And when, actually, for my birthday, we were out, and I felt like he was complimenting the waitress and just these random girls, like, oh, you have such a nice dress, and you look really good, and it's my birthday.
I mean,
why are you complimenting
him? How is it affecting your relationship?
I mean, it's kind of hard, because he doesn't trust me. You know, like, I'm from the South. I'm from Nashville, right? So I was raised on a country upbringing, which is... I was raised to be charming, be a gentleman, you know?
Southern charm.
So that's what I am.
You know, I do have to be on your side just for a second, because when we had the Cajun food truck here, that brother was so kind and polite. He was like, we can get started right away, baby.
There you go.
What is that? What? What happened? Well, I understand.
It was a Southern thing.
It's a Southern thing.
Morning, ma'am. You look lovely today. Right. It's very.
I speak my mind. So if I see somebody, hey, I love your dress. I love your eyes. Your beautiful eyes. I'm gonna say that. You know, it's not to
do
like.
Do you have to compliment everyone all the time?
If I see a man, the same thing. Hey, you have a nice blazer. You know, it just kind of it comes quick.
Think
you know,
it's too much. Though.
It comes quick. I mean, it's natural.
You guys can't take your relationship to the next level unless you accept who he is, and he's a flirt. I married a flirt, okay? Yeah. And you kind of have to tone that down, maybe, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I married a flirt, and he was monogamously challenged. So.
well, that's a whole different. Whoa!
I'm just saying.
That's a whole different issue.
I'm just saying. Yeah, I bet you're right. Separate issue. I'm just saying that that's kind of who he is. So.
How did you get past it though when he was going out without you and you got? Did you ever get nervous that he was just gonna, you know, be a little too friendly or extra with these girls?
Go ahead. Go ahead, baby.
No, you know what? I gotta say that my husband is a hunk of mola heartthrob, and the women scream. Yes, they scream his name everywhere he goes. But one thing that my husband did do is that he made me calm by the way he behaved. He didn't get too wrapped up in the woman that was trying to get wrapped up with him.
Right,
he didn't exchange phone numbers or compliment too many people. He made sure I was calm. And that I wasn't insecure in these social situations. So after a few months of investing in just being centered and calm and focused, I let it go. And I suspect she might let it go too.
Christian, let me give you a piece of advice here. Now, you gotta handle your business.
Right on.
And what that means is, as she just so eloquently expressed, when women come up to you, you have to let them know in so many words that number one, you're taken, and that all your attention goes towards one woman, which is sitting right next to you, right? Right?
Go ahead,
please.
Can I chime in on that?
Yes.
Also, you have to understand that that makes her uncomfortable, right? So if it makes her uncomfortable, you have to be sympathetic to that, right? And understand that, and put her first. Put her out there. So if you're complimenting everyone else in the room and not really spending enough time on her, it's gonna continue to make her uncomfortable. Right. She's gotta be 99%, and that other compliment's gonna be 1%, right?
So it's a two-way street, we both have.
I mean, for sure.
How do you feel about this advice? I'm curious.
I mean, I definitely agree with it, you know, completely, you know, as far as me putting her first. And I feel like I do, but maybe I can be more aware of it, you know? It's just sometimes, like, we'll go out in public, and I'll run into some of my female friends, and we'll start chatting, and I can feel her, like, on my, you know, my neck. You know what I mean?
She's, wait, you still have female friends?
I do have female friends.
Holly sent them all to the island.
Well, thank you so much to our couple.
They're so cute.
Christian Haley for coming out, sharing your story. And a special thanks to our friends Holly and Rodney for stopping by. For more information on a new docuseries for Pete's Sake and the Holly Rod Foundation's Design Care Gala, please visit our Facebook page. We'll be right back. Our next guest graced Broadway as one of the original Dream Girls. She sashayed into our hearts in Waiting to Exhale and took home an Emmy for her role on Grey's Anatomy. Now, she's starring in the new sitcom, The Carmichael Show. Take a look.
I mean, Maxine moved in 3 weeks ago.
Well, congratulations.
This is exciting.
It is?
Yeah, it is.
Of course it is, unless you're sleeping in the same bed or anything like that.
Ma, don't.
I mean, the Bible is pretty clear on that one. Put a ring on it.
Put your hands together for the incomparable Miss Loretta Devine!
Yeah.
actor friends on this weird situation.
I know. Well, without a script, along. I feel.
You know, over the years, you have starred in so many iconic films and
I've
TV
been so
shows.
Blessed. Yes, thank yes. you.
What's your favorite memory of some of the work you've done?
Oh, God, I've worked with so many different people. Like Slapping Taraji. Eli Stone, that was one of my favorite things. Because she's so much fun to work with and everything.
I'll fix that for you. This is how we do it on the Boris and Nicole show.
You fixed that earring.
We look out for each other.
Nicole and I work together on two shows.
Oh, yes,
Come
King's
on,
Ransom.
Rebound.
Oh, and Rebound.
Yes, when we were babies.
Together in, King's Ransom. That's
yes.
Right. Amazing.
We had so much fun.
Yes. Okay, I'm back together.
You're back together.
Well, Loretta, now we're seeing more and more African-American women in leading roles on TV and on the big screen. You know, Empire and Grey's Anatomy. Have you felt that shift happen?
Oh, I'm really excited about it. I mean, I've been in the business, seemed like forever. I was there when the Lord's Supper, I served the wine. But to see so many women of color on screen, it just gives you such hope. I just hope that everything keeps going the way it's going. And it's such a blessing for everyone to be working at the same time. That's what I feel.
So tell us about the Carmichael Show.
The show is all about things that are happening right now. So we waited till the very last minute to film the shows. They're about the Confederate flag and protesting and racism and things that are very contemporary. So I think they're going to bring about a lot of conversation in families. Yes. It's just the opinions of this particular one family. Mm. And it's based on Gerard's life and his family. And so his mom evidently was very religious, and his father, David Alan Grier, says some of the most outlandish things you've ever heard.
How is it like working with him again?
It is crazy. You between hating and loving him at all times. Because he keeps you on your toes. You never know what he's going to do next. Aww. So it's really great.
Yes. Well, you know, everybody here knows that one of our favorite movies is Waiting to Exhale. Sashay, Gloria does her sexy sashay.
God.
And so, you know, we've been 10 years married and I kind of lost my shay.
Get out of here.
So I was hoping you could show me how to do it again. Would you like to see that?
Yeah. I'd love to see it too. Okay, which way are we going?
Okay, hold on.
Well, let's start
make
over
some
here.
Space.
Okay.
We're going to start over here.
Girlfriend, you need to show me. Look at you with all them legs. You bet she got the legs. Go ahead,
Boris. So I'm gonna follow you.
Okay.
Be sure to catch the premiere of The Carmichael Show, August 26th on NBC. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. Usually, love is the answer, but when it comes to cohabitating, sometimes you need a little bit more. You need an interior designer, so we brought one in. Please welcome our dear friend, superstar designer, Nikki Chu.
Now, Nikki, we have an engaged couple who recently moved in together and can't agree on a design plan for their living room. Now, he likes modern and she likes traditional. Please welcome Ali and Justin.
Now, Ali, you just moved into your fiance's house a few weeks ago. What are some of the major issues you're running into?
So just with organization, right? I'm a little more organized than he is. I like bins everywhere. Sure. If it doesn't have a place, it shouldn't be there.
Well, relax. This is very common.
Yes.
Okay. And then just our different styles. I like more, you know, antique rustic. He likes more modern sleek.
Justin, what about you? What are some of your major concerns?
Well, one of the other concerns is we have a difference in color palette. She likes a lot of bold colors, whereas I like more kind of calming, serene, blues, green, stuff like that. So.
Well, we have some of Ali and Justin's furniture here from their living room. So let's look at the first design dilemma, the wall color.
Right. Well, you can see that clearly both of their colors are extremely bold, and together this is a complete mess. So My design suggestion would be to neutralize the space. Okay. So kind of go into the palette that you're looking for, something a little more calm and neutral. So if we take this wall away, we'll actually see that I've painted this a color called Up in Smoke, which is from my paint line on Amazon.
Woo!
Yeah. So you can see right away that takes all of that chaos away. Mm-hmm. And one of my design suggestions is to take your colors and put it into a piece of art.
Oh.
Okay, so instead of trying to compromise, because paint is a big, bold suggestion, so make your walls neutral and bring it into your accessories. So why don't you remove your lamp here, because I'm going to show you how to bring that into all your accessories.
While you're doing that, I'm going to just ask Justin and Allie, like, you want to display, Allie wants to display some of her credentials and diplomas and awards.
She has a lot of awards.
Yes, and, but you don't want them all over the house.
No.
You don't want it to be like a shrine.
Yeah, like a shrine to Allie, because I don't have that many, like, at all.
Nikki, so, what would be the solution?
No, no. It's just an ego thing for me.
However, organization and storage is very key. So this is actually a great way to store some awards. Do it in a gallery setting. Make sure all the picture frames are cohesive. And then just kind of display it like this. So,
wow.
See, it looks much neater. Yeah, everything looks clean and organized.
See, it was the same for us because I have so many awards and diplomas and stuff.
Yeah, so it was difficult to showcase all of that.
She just got insecure about it, so I said, okay, I'll put it in the basement.
Yes.
I'll just put all my stuff in the garage.
And I love decorating with colors. So you can see perfectly, these are the colors that were in their palette. And right away,
it's like a transformation happening right before our eyes.
It's easy. It's easy. This is the best way when two people cannot agree on a color.
So how long are you guys married?
So we're getting married in November. We've known each other for 6 years, but we've been dating for 4 years.
Are you sure you want to get married?
Well,
look at this solution. Allie brought in all of her accessories and put right in.
You know, the reason why they're still willing to compromise is because they're not married. Because if they were married, Justin would know that everything Allie says goes.
Well, Boris, I do recall when you and Nicole moved, you didn't agree on the pinstripe wall.
And
this is after 10 years of marriage.
Then what happened to the pinstripe wall? It went away.
Well, it became the flooring.
That's right.
Yes. You know, Allie, you talked about with our producers how he leaves his vinyls all over the floor.
Yes.
And is there a way...
For a younger audience, vinyls is regular.
That's right. So there is a perfect solution for that, and storage is key in any home. So bookcases work perfectly for that. So I want to see the bookcase come in, and you'll see how we used all of your records and gave it its own space instead of the floor.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So.
That's perfect.
Look at that.
Yes. So this is a perfect solution to storage. You see, I have both your initials on there. but this is
and
perfect.
And got
for
the bigger letter.
Yes, obviously.
The wife. Yeah.
But really, in terms of designing, it's about neutralizing the wall. And the reason why I brought in all of this clean kind of palette is because that's the modern palette, okay?
Do you guys feel blended here?
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
They did an excellent job with the traditional and the rustic with all of these accent pieces. But to bring in the more modern, we did that with the painting.
Right.
And also modern is no patterns, kind of keeping that very clean. So this kind of represents the man. And then bringing in all the color and the accessories.
Nice.
Hey.
This is awesome.
Well, no fat hats for Justin. Thanks to extremely talented Nikki Chu. And best of all to Allie and Justin, who are getting married this November.
But before we go, Allie and Justin, there is one more surprise. You two are getting married in a few months, so we will be sending you on a 4-night, 5-day honeymoon at the all-inclusive St. James's Club in Antigua.
The property is tucked away on a private 100-acre peninsula on the southeast coast of Antigua with 2 white sand beaches, 6 pools, water sports, and activities.
Antigua and Barbuda is an ocean oasis with 365 beaches surrounded by stunning landscape. Anyone can escape to this paradise this summer and take advantage of the amazing views and deals. Go to Boris and Nicole. Was that an interruption, people?
Go to BorisandNicole.com to get more information on Antigua and Barbuda.
Thanks, Allie and Justin and Nikki for being here. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. If you love exploring the great outdoors but don't like roughing it in a tent, what are you doing?
I don't know.
Okay.
Then this could be for you. It's called Under Canvas Glamping.
I love this. Let's welcome glamping expert Sarah Dusick.
Hey, Sarah.
Hi.
Hi, Nicole.
How are you?
So nice to meet you. I'm great.
We consider ourselves a glamily. You're glamily.
You are, and you are glam.
And we want to go glamping.
Sounds fabulous.
Tell us all about it.
So these tents look great. What's the difference between glamping and camping?
The big difference, obviously, is the tents. You can experience the outdoors in amazing comfort and style. You have fully furnished tents. Mm-hmm. You have your own bathroom tent that we have over here with your own private shower and toilet. No queuing in the bath for a bathroom stall.
Wow.
It's right here with you.
And no sleeping bags on the ground
anymore. No having to lug all your stuff across the country. You just get to turn up like you would at a posh hotel. Turn up and enjoy the experience.
Where can you go glamping?
We have three locations across the U.S. We have one in Yellowstone in Montana. We have one in Moab, Utah, and in Glacier, also in Montana.
You know, when we were dating, he used to always say, you know, one day we're going to have a ranch in Montana.
That's right.
Come and stay with us.
We should go glamping.
Oh, absolutely. I love that. This is amazing.
Can you rent these tents?
Absolutely. We also have, in addition to our camps, we have an event business where we take our tents all over the U.S. and Canada. You can rent them for parties, weddings, corporate retreats.
Wow.
We did a big Eco Oscars lounge for Oscars this year. It's awesome.
Well, can we take a look inside?
Yeah, let's go. Let's go see.
Ooh.
So come and see. Oh. Come and try out the bed.
This is amazing.
A nice little nightcap.
Wow.
Yeah. Wowie.
So we've got full luxurious bedding and furnishings and end tables.
Nice.
Now, no getting sweet, you guys.
Oh, sorry.
Family show.
Yes.
And you can make your trip even more glamorous by adding some hall wines.
Ooh, let's have a little sip over there.
There you go.
It's the afternoon somewhere.
Nice.
You know, and by being here, you've made it possible that all of you can enjoy a luxury camping experience because Under Canvas is giving everyone in the audience a one-night stay at one of their amazing destinations. For more information, log on to BorisandNicole.com. Thank you, Sarah.
You're so welcome.
I can't wait. We'll be right back.
Look at that. Thing before we go, whether you're glamping, driving, or hiking, it's always good to be prepared for emergencies. So everyone in the audience is going home with the Rescue Me toolkit to stay safe.
For more information on the kit, visit our website at BorisandNicole.com. We had so much fun today.
Wow.
Thank you to our guests, Zendaya.